Welcome back to another very exciting tutorial here at the PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com. My name is Jesus Ramirez, and you can find me on Twitter at JRFromPTC. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create a line drawing from a photo in Photoshop. We'll start out with the same stock photo that I used for the Mockingjay movie poster tutorial, and we'll apply a few effects to give it that pencil drawing look. This effect is actually very straightforward. You can apply it to almost any image, but keep in mind that it will look better when you have a subject with a white background. Also, you can follow along with me if you like, but if you're using your own image, you may have to enter different values on the filters that we apply so that they work on your photo. Okay, let's get started. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the background and I'm going to click and drag it over to the new layer icon. Then I'm going to create a new black and white adjustment layer. That's going to turn everything black and white. I don't need the properties, so I'm just going to click on the double-sided arrow to collapse the panel. Then on the background copy, I'm going to switch the blending mode to color dodge. And what color dodge does is it creates a stronger or more contrasted version of screen. If I go into screen, you see what that creates. Color dodge, similar to screen, but more contrast. Then I'm going to invert the colors. That means that the light colors will become dark and the dark colors will become light. And you can do so by pressing Control I on the keyboard or by going into Image, Adjustment, Invert. But Control I or Command I on the Mac is much faster. And you'll notice what happens. Everything sort of disappears except for the black pixels. If I come back into screen, you'll see what that does. It essentially washes everything out because only the light colors are showing. But if you intensify that effect, everything is gone except for the really, really dark pixels. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to right-click on the layer, click on Convert to Smart Object. If you're using a version of Photoshop that does not have Smart Objects, you don't have to worry about this step. The only reason I'm creating a Smart Object is so that I can have Smart Filters and I can edit them later. But you don't have to do that. You can just go into Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur, and create the blur without a smart object. And I'll show you why a smart object is beneficial. But anyway, when you start blurring the image, you'll start seeing the outline of the image come back. And this is what's going to create the basis of our line drawing. And the radius that you should select is whatever looks good for your image. All the effects that I'm going to show you today in the filters will have different settings if you're using a different photograph or if you want to get a different effect. So don't be so specific about the settings that I use. Just look at the technique and adjust the settings accordingly to your image. For this image, somewhere around maybe 1.9 or around there looks like it'll work. I get a lot of detail on the face and on the jacket. Some of these lines are too dark, but I think I can work with them. So I'm just going to leave the radius at 1.9 for now, and I'm going to press OK. You can see that the Gaussian blur was applied to the smart filter, and the reason I created a smart object was that I could double click on the Gaussian blur smart filter to come back into the Gaussian blur window and adjust the effect if necessary. I'm not going to do that, but I just wanted to give you that option in case you needed to make adjustments down the line. I'm going to click on this up pointing arrow to collapse the smart filter just to give it a little more room. At this point, you might want to call this done depending on the effect that you want to achieve, but we want to create a much more realistic effect, so I'm going to show you a few filters that are going to help us achieve that goal. I'm going to click on the background copy. Instead of clicking and dragging it to the new layer icon, this time I'm going to press Control J, Command J on the Mac, which duplicates the layer. I'm going to click and drag it to the very top. Now I'm going to go into Image, Adjustments, Desaturate, which desaturates the image. Then I'm going to go into Filter, Filter Gallery, and I'm going to select Stylize Glowing Edges. And this is going to help us create an outline around an image that are going to mimic pencil lines. And you can play with the edge width to get the width that's appropriate for the look that you're going for, the edge brightness, and the smoothness. For me, edge width of 1, edge brightness of 4, and smoothness of 5 works. I'm going to press OK. Now the lines are white and the background is black. I want the opposite. And we already know how to invert colors. We did it just a minute ago. So I'm going to press Control I, Command I on the Mac to invert this layer. Then I'm going to use a blend mode to get rid of the white pixels and keep the black. To do so, I'm going to go into Multiply. Multiply makes the white pixels invisible and it makes the dark pixels visible. So now I have an outline for my drawing. What I'm going to do now is I want to create some shading around my drawing, but I want to use something that looks like pencil marks. To do so, I'm going to click on the background layer again, press Ctrl J, Command J on the Mac, click and drag that duplicate all the way to the top. We're going to desaturate it. This time, I'm just going to press Ctrl Shift U. That's Command Shift U on the Mac. And if you forgot, you can also get to that by going into Adjustments and Desaturate. The shortcut's right here. Now I'm going to apply a different filter. So I'm going to go into Filter, Filter Gallery, and this time I'm going to apply one of the filters found in the Sketch section, and I'm going to choose Charcoal. And that's going to create this etching effect. It looks a lot like pencil lines, and that's what I want to use. Charcoal Thickness 1, Detail 4, Light and Darkness 48. Again, you may want to play with these settings to get a different look on your image if you're going for something different. Press OK when you're done. This time we don't need to do any inversions, but we do need to get rid of the white and keep the black. So we're going to change the blend mode to multiply, and we get this effect. So now we have the original line drawing with some extra lines to help us define the drawing a bit more, and these etch lines that make it look a lot like a pencil drawing. If I zoom in, I'm going to select the zoom tool by pressing Z on the keyboard, and I'm just going to zoom in, and you can see how this looks a lot like a drawing already. The problem that I see is that I lost a lot of detail in the eyes, so I want to bring some of that detail back. I'm going to press B on the keyboard to bring up my brush tool. Then I'm going to make the brush a little bit bigger, so maybe something about this big. And what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to paint with black on the layer mask. I haven't created a layer mask yet, so I'm going to click on this layer mask icon to add a layer mask. And if you remember, when you paint with black on a layer mask, it hides the pixels that are selected. I'm going to press X to switch the foreground and background color, so the foreground color is now black. And if I paint with black on the layer mask, it hides the pixels that were there before. And I'm going to do the same thing on this side. And maybe if I have a smaller brush, I can create a better defined eye layer. And I maybe make it bigger again. And by the way, I'm using the bracket keys on the keyboard to adjust the brush size. I'm going to zoom out by holding Alt and using the mouse wheel just to see the effect that I have. And I don't like how this eye, the right eye is looking, so maybe I'll hide that entire area and maybe this area too. And then we're going to work with this a little later on to give it more definition. So I'm using masks to hide the filters that I'm not happy with. And you can do that with the rest of the image. I'm not going to for this tutorial. I'm just going to do the eyes, but at least you know the technique so you can apply it to your image. What I'm going to do now is add one more layer. This time, I'm going to use the Wacom tablet to draw. If you don't have one, don't worry. I'm going to show you how you can apply these effects with the mouse first. And what I'm going to do is I want to just create some lines around the image to further enhance the effect of a pencil drawing. What you want to do if you're using a mouse is get a really small brush, maybe 1 or 2 pixels. Let's start with 1 and see how that looks. And I'm just going to paint. And that looks pretty good, but maybe the opacity is too much. I'm going to bring that down to maybe 56%. And I'll probably bring the flow down, and I'm going to paint now. And that's looking much better. This is looking more like the pencil lines that you see here. So I'm just going to press Ctrl-Alt-Z, Command-Option-Z on the Mac to undo. And I'm going to zoom into the image, and I'm just going to start painting in some areas. And now that I'm painting on it, I actually think it's too dark. And I'm going to get rid of those lines by pressing Ctrl-Alt-C, Command-Option-Z on the Mac, and maybe bring the opacity down even further, maybe 35%. And now that I'm painting, I'm sort of liking it better. So now I'm creating lines in here. I'm filling in areas that I think need detail, maybe like the earlobe here. The ear needs a little more detail. And it's okay if you don't draw perfectly. This is more of a sketch look. So it's okay if you go over the lines and you know, you have that hand drawing look. That's what we're going for. So as you can see, I'm just simply painting with the mouse. I'm not using my Wacom tablet yet. So that's how you would do this technique using the mouse. Now, obviously, if you have a Wacom tablet, it's a lot easier, not only because it's easier to draw with a pen, but you have pressure sensitivity. So I'm going to bring the flow all the way to 100%, opacity 100%. And if you're using a Wacom tablet, make sure this button is pressed so you can use pressure sensitivity when you draw. So I'm not really going to draw too much. What I want to do is actually do two things. I want to enhance the hand-drawn look, and I want to fix areas that don't have a lot of detail. So for example, I can come into the nose here and maybe add a shape that will help enhance the nose, like so. What I also want to do is in areas where there are shadows, maybe I want to apply some lines that look hand-drawn, like so. And I'm not doing too much. I'm essentially scribbling on these areas just to make it hand-drawn, like so. Add a little more detail in the ears. Maybe come back and work on the eyes a little bit, make the eyelashes a little bit darker. And I'm going to go a little bit faster. All I'm really doing is creating this hand-drawn look on the edges here, just to make it a little more realistic. Also, in areas like the hair down here, I can maybe do something like this to make the hair stand out a little bit better. And again, in areas where there are shadows, maybe draw more lines that look hand-drawn like that. And I'm not doing too much, as you can see. And something you may want to do on edges like this, maybe you extend the lines out and it looks more like a hand drawing. As you look through your image, you may find areas like this where the filter didn't do that good of a job, so you may want to hide it by just painting over it like so. And obviously the more time that you spend, the better results that you get, but you get the idea. One thing that I am going to do is in areas like this where there's not a lot of detail, I can come in and just paint a line along the edge just to give it more definition. And again, in this area, I'm just gonna do some very, very light strokes here. And if you're thinking to yourself, in areas like this is gonna be really hard with the mouse, and yeah, it is. It's obviously a lot harder to draw with the mouse than it is with the Wacom tablet. But it can be done, you just gotta take your time. In areas like this, I'm just gonna go the opposite direction of those strokes, that way it looks a little more like a hand drawing. And again, create those edges there. And I'm not going to take too much more time because I think the filters did a really good job, but I just wanted you to see how you can further enhance the image if you needed to. I'm going to double click on the zoom tool just to go to 100%, and you can see our final drawing there. And once you have everything completed, one thing you may want to do is this. I'm going to add a new solid color. I'm just going to make it white. I'm going to disable this layer. Then I'm going to go into the channels panel. And I'm going to select any one of these channels. It doesn't really matter which one, they're all the same. We're working with a black and white image, so they're all going to be 100% the same. So choose one, click and drag it over onto the new channel icon to duplicate it, select it, and then press Control I on the keyboard, Command I on the Mac to invert. Now we're going to create a selection out of the light pixels, which are the pencil marks. I'm going to press Control, Command on the Mac, click on the channel copy thumbnail to make a selection around those light pixels. Come back into the layers panel, enable the white color fill, and select another solid color. You can choose black if you want to, but you can also choose a different color. Maybe you had a drawing with a blue pen or something like that. I'm just going to select the dark gray and press OK. Now the image is being created just by this solid color in this layer mask. If I hold Alt Option on the Mac and click on the layer mask icon, you'll see what the layer mask looks like. I'm going to hold Alt and click on the layer mask icon again. Now, if you want to make any further adjustments at this point, you will have to make them on the layer mask, but I recommend making all the adjustments before you get to this point. That way, what you see on the layer mask is the finished product. And of course, you can change the color of the background, which is now white, to something else, or maybe add a paper texture or something like that to make things more realistic. And that's it for this tutorial. If you have any comments or questions, please leave them down below. If you found this video useful, share it with a friend and hit that like button. And of course, don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.